Hello, in this video, we will discuss special allowances exempted up to specified limit under Section 10, Subsection 14, Clause 1, Part 1. Special allowances exclusively incurred in performing official duties under Section 10, Subsection 14, Clause 1. The following are special allowances notified by Central Government of India under this section. There are total 6 allowances. Number 1. Travelling allowance, number 2, daily allowance, number 3, helper allowance, number 4, conveyance allowance, number 5, uniform allowance, number 6, academic allowance. Number 1 is travelling or transfer allowance. This allowance is granted to meet the cost of tour or travel. The cost of travel includes sum granted for transfer, packing and transportation for personal use too. It is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. Let us take example. Mr. Harman has been transferred from Ambala to Jalandhar. He has been granted rupees 5000 as transfer allowance and rupees 700 for packing. He actually spent only rupees 5500. The remaining rupees 200 is taxable in the hands of Mr. Harman. Second is daily allowance. Amount incurred to meet the ordinary daily charges incurred by the employee during his or her tour, travel on account of his or her absence from normal place of work. Here also it is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. For example, Mr. Harman had been paid rupees 300 per day for 10 days as daily allowance to meet his official tour expenses. He had spent rupees 250 per day for 10 days. The balance rupees 500 will be taxable income in the hands of Mr. Harman. Third is helper allowance. This allowance is granted to meet the expenditure incurred for engaging helper for performance of official work. It is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. For example, Mr. Harman has been transferred from Ambala to Jalandhar. He has been granted permission to engage helper for heavy work. For this, Mr. Harman has been paid rupees 800 per month as helper allowance. Mr. Harman took the services of helper and he paid rupees 600 per month to helper. Now rupees 200 in the hands of Mr. Harman is taxable. Fourth one is conveyance allowance. This allowance is granted to meet expenses incurred on the conveyance in performance of official duties. It is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. For example, Mr. Harman has been paid rupees 300 per month as conveyance allowance to meet conveyance expenditure for official work. He has spent only rupees 250 per month. Now, rupees 250 per month is exempted and excess will be taxable. That is, rupees 50 per month will be taxable. Fifth point is uniform allowance. The amount is granted to employee for purchasing or maintaining official uniform during performance of official duties. It is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. Example is, Mr. Ramlal is working as a security guard and he has to wear a proper uniform on his duty. For this, he is getting rupees 250 per month as uniform allowance. He has spent rupees 200 per month on its maintenance. Now, rupees 50 per month will be taxable. But if he has spent rupees 300 per month on its maintenance, then whole amount, that is rupees 250 per month, will be exempted and nothing will be taxable in the hands of Mr. Ramlal. The last point is academic allowance. This type of allowance is granted for encouraging employees for improving their performance academically, or for research purposes, or for enrolling themselves for other professional courses. It is exempted up to actual expenditure incurred for the performance of duty. Excess, if any, will be taxable. For example, Mr. Prashottam is an associate professor in a university, getting rupees 300 per month as academic allowance for carrying on his research work. He spent rupees 280 per month. Here, rupees 20 per month will be only taxable. Watch next video for the treatment of special allowances to meet personal expenses under Section 10, Subsection 14, Clause 2, Part 2. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Subscribe this channel for more videos. Keep watching. Keep learning. Bye-bye.